how long it takes this to become this. Thumbnail achieved. But seriously, people ask me this all the time. They're like, how long does it take you to make a mug? I'm like, well, I think 15 to 20 minutes. But that's just a go-to answer. I just make that up, essentially. Let's talk about it. How long does it take you to make a mug?
If you've ever done pottery, people ask you this question. People kind of wanted you to justify your price. There's a lot going on here. It's a loaded question.
All right, so we're gonna go through the whole process. I'm gonna document everything, time everything, average it out, see how long each mug takes in the whole process. There's a lot that goes into this process, way more than most people think. So if you've never seen the whole thing, stick around. It's gonna be a pretty interesting video. It's gonna be some new stuff you might not have known about. And it might give you a little bit more appreciation for how nice them mugs come out. Time to get started. First, we gotta clean up a little bit. This only takes 4 minutes, which is about 9 seconds per mug. So the first thing we gotta do, we gotta turn this 25-pound bag of clay into 1-pound balls of clay. We'll cut everything up, weigh it out. When you're making an order, you want all the mugs to be the same, so you weigh everything out so it's the same weight. If it's the same weight, it'll be relatively the same size. Once everything's weighed out, I'll wedge the clay into a ball and stick it in a bag. The total time to weigh and wedge the clay takes 24 seconds. Okay, once everything's weighed out, it's time to go to the wheel. You'll see I use the Studio Pro bat system. This helps me save time by I can just lift these bats right out and set them onto my trays and not have to worry about touching the mug and distorting it. I'll link to that in the description if you're interested. This is one of the areas where I've increased my time a bunch. Back in the day, it used to take me like 30 minutes on the wheel when I first started. For the longest time, I was stuck at 5 minutes. I couldn't get anything less than that. And then this last year, I've just been able to speed it up. This time making these 25, it took me 120 seconds, or right at 2 minutes per mug. One of the things that I do to try to save time is throw the whole mug with just 3 pulls. 3 pulls is the perfect number to get exactly what I need with height and my wall thickness, and it saves me time. Once the mugs are firmed up a little bit, it's time to cut them off the bats and flip them over. You'll see I scrape the bats too. I flip them over so they dry evenly and cover them with plastic. This doesn't take very long, just 10 seconds per mug. All right, next, come over here. Got this Giffen grip here. No, I always say Griffin grip like I'm Harry Potter man. And I got some trimming tools. And so we're gonna get a bunch of these little curly cues. But we're gonna go trim this thing. I keep them covered with plastic at this point because I don't want them to dry out any more than they already are. I've got it to my perfect moisture content. First we trim it, then I use a metal rib to just smooth the whole thing out. Flop that one off, grab the next one. You can see this one's got the little foot on it, so it won't be as much to do here. We're just gonna kinda set that round, smooth it out. Boom, all right. Now just a bunch more to go. Total time to trim each mug is 48 seconds. Now it's time to make handles. I take some clay, I start squeezing it. Looks kind of like a coil, but it's not quite a very smooth coil because I can't make a very good coil. Just take a block of clay and just start squishing. It's like a hammerhead shark. Whew, that's gonna look weird on the time lapse. Just like this, start squeezing.
We gotta find our knife, which I lost.
I cut the coils to length and then shape them into my handle block so they're ready to go onto the mug. Total time to coil, cut, and shape is 36 seconds. Next step in the process, take these little guys that we made, stick them on the mug. Put a little scratchy scratchy on it. Throw a little water in the mix. Then we stick it on. Gotta pull the handle. Basically, you just gotta pull it to where it gets to the size that you want. Stick it on. Just like that, you've got a handle. So let's get this done, huh? Here you can see, I got a movie going on while I'm pulling the handle. You gotta put something on you're not too interested in. because you kind of do need to be looking at what you're doing. I pull my handles on the mug because it saves me time. So for me, this is the most efficient way and it gives me the most desirable handle. Not everybody feels this way, but for me, it's great. Total time to pull handles is 125 seconds.
Now the real fun begins. So what we do here then is we cut some clay off and we run it through this here machine, which is called a slab roller. Here we go. That should do. Let's roll it. Steer the ship, man. Little steer the ship. Roll this here thing out. Oi, buddy, look at that. We got ourselves a slab. We're gonna take our sock with some cornstarch, our stamp and our cookie cutters, and we're gonna get to work. Basically, we gotta cover all this with cornstarch. Then we're gonna use our stamp to stamp everything in, and then we cut it out. Let's do it.
The total time for me to roll out the slab, make the stamps, cut them out, is 35 seconds apiece.
All right, hey, how you doing up there? So now we take our little medallions here, and we're gonna put them on this mug, scratch the back here. And we put it on the piece. Scratchy, scratch. A little water. A little bit of brush. Oh, look at that, huh? Ain't she a beaut?
It takes me 98 seconds to attach a label to each mug. So we've got to the point now where these beautiful mugs here have dried out. They're bone dry, as they say. If you're ever trying to figure out a way to tell if these mugs are dry, if you put medallions on stuff like this, if there's any moisture behind here, these will blow up in the kiln. It's a terrible experience. Trust me, I've got way too much experience with it.
Oh, there's a lot of carnage here. You really, really hate to see it.
Anyways, besides the proper bisque firing, you can also do the cheek test. Hold it to your cheek, and if it's cool at all to the touch, it means there's still moisture in there. These feel great, so we're gonna go ahead and stamp them up. I use this guy here, my fancy stamp, which I need to wash off because it's covered in white underglaze. Let's stamp these up.
Get that thing inked up.
The stamps go really quick. I dry all the mugs upside down to have a more even drying time. It only takes me 5 seconds apiece.
We've got everything stamped. Now this is why I like having these wheeled carts. See, I wheel this over to my kiln. Now we're about to load up the bisque. This is pretty simple. We just take the pieces,
set them in. Loading the bisque doesn't take very long, just 6 seconds a piece, because it doesn't matter if anything touches. You just cram it in there, make sure the shelf isn't gonna hit it, and you're good to go. Now, the firing, though, takes a little bit longer. It takes about 15 hours for that bisque firing to do its whole cycle. Total time, though, from about the time I start the bisque to when I can unload it is about 25 to 30 hours. Just depends on how tight it's packed, how cold it is outside, and if the heat's on in the studio. Okay, I'll be honest, at this point, I'm a mixed bag of emotions. Part of me is like, wow, I'm going so much faster than I thought I would. Part of me is like, oh no, there's no way we're gonna be under 15 minutes. We might even be over 20 minutes. So what do you think? How fast do you think I'm going? I know I've been telling you the times, but am I going faster or slower than you thought I would? Bisque is done. Let's unload this beast. Unloading goes really quick, just 4 seconds per piece. Okay, next it's time to paint the label on these mugs.
Take a little underglaze, paint in this spot here. So we just paint it in, and then boom, that one's ready to go.
Total time to paint the labels, wipe it all off, and get those ready is 120 seconds.
Once that dries, grab a sponge here, and then just wipe off the excess. Just like that. You can read it. Once that's done, fill in the rest of it. Any little spot that needs to be filled in. Main one on these is this outside ring.
Josh, you make a mistake.
That's okay, man. We just wipe it away. Look at this, very good.
Next step in the process, wax. Okay, so the wax gets painted on. So we take the wax and we just paint it on the label. This is gonna seal it in. We don't wipe it away. So the wax keeps the glaze from sticking to it. We gotta paint the wax on all the logos. Then we'll sponge the bottom with another layer of wax.
Okay, so if you're enjoying this video, could you do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button at the bottom? I'd appreciate it.
It takes 16 seconds to wax the label and 13 seconds for me to sponge on the wax on the bottom. You gotta be careful not to drip on the pieces, because if you drip, no glaze is gonna stick in that spot.
After that,
We go to the old dry erase board.
We just start scribbling down notes. Do white and blue.
Basically what I'm doing is I start scratching down all the glaze combos that I'm gonna use. I also write down what order I need to glaze those in so that I only have to open a glaze up once. And then I'm gonna come over here, grab my test tiles, and I use these to lay out which glazes I'm doing. Like, let's say this was a whole row. I'd be like, yeah, this is gonna be this glaze combo.
I'm gonna grab these rolly shelves over here,
and then we're gonna start organize it, getting it ready, and then we're gonna start glazing. It took me 11 seconds per piece to organize everything and get it ready to glaze. Now, the organizer might seem kind of weird, but this saves me so much time. Making sure that I only open a glaze once is a huge factor in this. Now, if everything is just streamlined, you'd be surprised. This is a spot where you can make up a ton of ground. It used to take me half a day to glaze like 30 pieces, but now that I started doing this way, where I organize everything, I get it ready, I'm so much more efficient. Now it's time to glaze. You can see the wax working here as the glaze doesn't stick to these areas and starts to run off. Some pieces are gonna get just one glaze and they'll be just one solid color. Others get two or three glazes on them to give the desired effect. It takes me 89 seconds per piece to do the whole glazing process. We got everything glazed. Pretty crazy how this is gonna turn into something totally different. I'll see if I can remember which one this is and show you afterwards. Hey, if you wanna see more videos like this, hit that subscribe button. So everything's glazed up. Now we just gotta load it up. These carts are really nice to wheel over. Use my sponges to wipe them off a lot. And then, yeah, it's time to load it up. Loading the glaze kiln takes a little bit longer because I have to make sure none of the pieces touch. You also gotta make sure everything's wiped off because any glaze that gets on the shelf, it's gonna stick and it's gonna ruin the piece and the shelf. In total time, it takes me 21 seconds to load the glaze kiln per piece. This is a mug where the glaze dripped onto the shelf. You can see it chipped away at the piece itself. All right, we got the kiln cooling down. It is blustery outside, that is for sure. I've been wanting to do this video for a long time. I'm freaking stoked. Can't wait to see how it turns out. Now, for the fun part of the process. Yeah, my not fully loaded kiln. Yeah, everything's looking good. Ooh, I love that one. All right, well, now we just gotta let it cool down a little bit, then we'll unload it and sand the bottoms, and then we can box them up and take them to the store. Unloading the kiln goes quick again, just 5 seconds per piece. Next step is sanding the bottoms of these. So these are just a little bit rough. We just take some sandpaper and just hit them with a quick, oh, about like that. That's all you need. But yeah, so these just need a little bit of sanding and they'll be good to go. You know, I may have to do this outside, because you don't want to breathe this dust in, but it's below zero outside today, so we're gonna do it inside today in front of the air filter, and I'll have a mask on, so I'll just start sanding. This only takes about 12 seconds per piece.
Boxed up. Ready to go.
So I got the list right here. I added everything up. I'm actually kind of surprised. I'll be honest, there was a few areas that I didn't think were gonna take the amount of time they took, or I thought they were gonna take less time. Or more time, I don't know. There was a lot of things that I wasn't expecting on here. One of the big ones was the throwing. It used to take me so long, like I said earlier in the video, it used to take me a long time to throw. For the longest time, I was stuck at that 5 minute mark, but this time being able to get it down to that 2 minute average was crazy. I had to make about 100 of these retail mugs for this order. So I did time some of these things multiple times to see what the average would be. So I'll show you that in some of these. But it ended up being a total difference of, it ended up being a total difference of like 23 seconds per piece. So there's a big swing. This number doesn't necessarily represent how long it takes every single time, because if you're in a good mood or a bad mood, this number might go up or down, especially things like being on the wheel, pulling handles, really monotonous stuff like attaching the labels or stamping and cutting out the labels. That's one where I can lose all sorts of time. If I'm not in a good headspace, I'm just like, ugh, I don't wanna be here. I go so slow with that. Did you comment and tell me what your guess was for how long you thought it would take me? That's what I wanna know. All right, it's time to run down the list. Let's calculate everything and see where we stand. So, cleaning up, 9 seconds. Weighing out the clay, wedging everything up, 24 seconds. Throwing the mugs, 120 seconds.
This is one where I timed it separately and I got 125 seconds the second time. So that was just a 5 second difference. So I was pretty in the zone for those. Cutting off the pieces and then scraping the bats, that took 10 seconds per piece. Making the handle blocks, that was 36 seconds. And I timed it the second time, it was 37 seconds. So that one's pretty consistent. Trimming all the pieces took 48 seconds. Pulling the handles, 125 seconds. This is one where there's a big variety. Second time I timed it took 134 seconds. Okay, cutting out the labels, that took 35 seconds. Attaching the labels, that took 98 seconds. The second time I timed that, it took 105 seconds. Stamping my logo on the bottom, 5 seconds. Loading the bisque, 6 seconds. Unloading the bisque, 4 seconds. Painting the labels, wiping everything off, so that was 120 seconds. Waxing the labels, 16 seconds. Waxing the bottoms, 13 seconds. Thinking about the glazes, 2 seconds. Organizing all the pieces, 11 seconds. Glazing, 89 seconds. Loading the glaze kiln, 21 seconds. Unloading the glaze kiln, 5 seconds. Sanding everything, 12 seconds. And so that brings me to a grand total of 13 minutes and 29 seconds. Or 13 minutes and 52 seconds the second time. So that's pretty crazy. I can't believe I was able to keep it under 15 minutes. That one really surprised me. But we gotta add the caveats. This doesn't mean that I can sit down and crank out 4 mugs per hour that I work in a week. Because then I'd be easily doing 100 mugs in a 40-hour work week. Because there's all sorts of stuff that doesn't go into this. I gotta make the glazes, clean the studio. I gotta go down and get the clay. I gotta deliver orders. When I go to shows, I gotta pack everything up and then drive it to the show. So this is just the making process. So it's just a tiny part of the whole process. So just out of curiosity, I wanted to look and see how long it would take me if I cut out the whole stamp process. Okay, so if I cut out the labels, I can make the mugs in 8 minutes and 55 seconds. But then the things about those, when I make my normal mugs, I have to either package them up, ship them out, or take them to a show, or sell them some other way. I don't just get to drop them off. So the advantage of wholesale is I drop it off and it's done. If you're interested in doing this yourself, which I totally think you should, you're gonna need a stopwatch and just a piece of paper, that's all you need. And just start the timer when you sit down. I think it's best to do this in a batch. I mean, you could do it in a batch of 5 or 10 or 20. The more pieces you put in the batch, the more accurate your number's gonna be. Time the whole process when you sit down at the wheel to when you're done at the wheel for the throwing part, just like you saw me do. But basically, you're gonna write all that out. I work everything in seconds and then divide it and see what you get. Divide it by 60 at the end to see how many minutes you get, and then you'll be there. So leave me a note, tell me how fast you are on the wheel, and what did you think? Was it faster or slower than you thought it would be? What surprised you in the process? What did you think was not gonna take so long? Were you surprised in all the steps that it takes? I mean, there's 21 processes here, and some of those are combined. So it's probably closer to 25 steps to make a mug. Who knew? Who knew that was the thing? I wouldn't have guessed it was that many pieces. Obviously not. If you're new here, hit the like, subscribe, and follow me, and check out more of these videos. And what do you want to see next? Okay, bye.